just want to return to this idea that enlightenment, in a spiritual sense, if that's the right word, can be seen as being coincident with intellectual engagement, or rather the adoption of a mindset which acknowledges the tenets of intellectual engagement. Things like methodological naturalism, the scientific method, objectivity, interpersonal validation, justification, verification methods, those kind of things to do with which unite individuals into larger intellectual and academic communities or entities, and also link those communities and entities with the natural, methodological, natural world, if you like. I think one of the things that kind of stands in the way of that, I think I sort of hinted in the previous video, is that there's an assumption that enlightenment must be accompanied with a certain feeling of being in which one must feel oneself to be enlightened. I don't really know what that must feel like, although of course I've had quite a lot of odd feelings myself at various times. Possibly a feeling of joy, maybe, or of kind of overwhelming connectedness, or a feeling of ego loss, or maybe all sorts of things, I don't know, but a feeling of being illuminated from the inside. I know that's highly metaphorical, but there might be a set of feelings associated with enlightenment. But, I mean, the first problem with that is there's no guarantee that such feelings actually correspond to anything other than an unusual state of consciousness, which might in itself be fine, but again, that's not, in my book at least, a good enough reason to call oneself enlightened just because you feel a bit funny. And also, it assumes that enlightenment is only those feelings, that those they are the limit of what enlightenment is. But it seems quite reasonable to me to understand that enlightenment might be something that exists prior to or disconnected to the feelings that we might associate with it. I can't think of an analogy for that, I'll give it some thought. But it seems quite likely to me that any enlightenment worth its salt would not require me to feel a certain way about it or to have certain attitudes towards it. Although I recognise that there may be a sort of default emotional sensibility attached to it. Also, what I'm thinking of is that if intellection and enlightenment are kind of correspondent terms, and that an adoption of what you might call a rational position is equivalent in some ways to enlightenment, then why aren't all the scientists in the world running around saying how enlightened they are? And why aren't every school child suddenly having this moment of Advaita in the first science class? It's not happening, is it? So I'm guessing that what we're seeing there is a kind of banalization of the idea, or a normalization of the idea. We seek enlightenment. When we seek enlightenment, we seek something else. We seek something other than the way we feel routinely. And the way we tend to feel routinely right now is 21st century rational, more or less. With all of the assumptions to do with interpersonal objectivity and methodological naturalism that comes with it. We're a scientifically grounded society, if you like. So in a sense, we're born enlightened and we live our life enlightened. We just don't realize that's the case because we're so busy looking somewhere else for an appropriate feeling to attach to it or a set of practices that we think will produce those feelings. In a sense, I think this is precursored in some of the writings, like in Buddhist literature, for example. I think it says things like, you know, that enlightenment is coming to the realization that you are already enlightened. It isn't a place you get to, that you have to travel to. It's a place you already are. You just have to open your eyes in a certain way, look in a certain way to see that certain thing. So really, it's not really a question of learning something new. It's about trying to avoid the trap of being in search of something that you haven't already got. I think this is something that poet. Anyway, it'll come back to me. But he says something like, more, more, more is the cry of the disquiet man, I think, or something like that. And we do seem to be in that situation. Okay, so if we're already always enlightened, it's a question of not accepting that the world is as banal as it might seem, and embracing that banality, apparent banality. If you want to see things differently, you have to look differently. Everything is already wide awake. Everything is already brightly illuminated.